do yourself a favor and for those people around you, and try doing something kind. I know it seems easy, but really it's an effort that you would make to just do something kind once a day. I know somebody who does it all day long. It's part of her life. It's my friend Lou Parker from KTLA. It's so nice to see you, Lou. You've actually created a company called Be Kind & Co.
I have, and before we get to any of that, we have to let everyone know you are Superman.
You went right for it. And you are Francis, my neighbor from across the hall.
So long story short, we used to work together at KTLA. Our offices were about 6 feet apart. And as we finished up the show, we would go into our offices. He would close his door, take off his suit, flip it around, and then all of a sudden be in his casual attire, like flip-flops, t-shirt attire. And so I called him Superman because he did it in like 5 seconds. So, and then my first name is Francis, and not too many people are allowed to call me that, except Eric Spillman and you call me Francis.
We're the two lucky ones, huh?
Yes. Well, yeah. You guys were grandfathered in.
Those were the days, and I so, you know, have such great memories of working with you and sitting on the set and co-anchoring with Lou, who I called Francis.
And, yeah.
You know, it's interesting because those were still very formative days, even though I think we worked together for a couple of years at KTLA before I moved on. But, you know, we have such great memories and such a family feeling. It's one of those unusual places where you actually feel very, very close to your coworkers, don't you think?
Yeah, you do. And I agree. And people have come and gone, and then some have like stayed. And it's a really nice environment. And it's been like that even through different management too, which says a lot.
Yeah, that's amazing. And of course you're terrific. And this is interesting because you're a South Carolina girl. You're a Southern person, right? You're from the South.
For sure.
And you love the South and you carry the South with you. You were Miss America. You have 6 Emmys. You've done really well in your life.
Yeah.
And you just seem to constantly be creating new things that really speak of who Lou Parker is all about. So I want to get back to that Be Kind & Company thing.
Oh, thanks, Carlos. You know, I started it 3 years ago, which is crazy to think that it's been that long. Coming up, I think, on 4 years this summer, it came from a place of an incident happened to me, and I was trying to be kind to someone, and it totally backfired and just flipped my world upside down and made me question a lot of things in life. In fact, it made me question kindness. And, you know, I really struggled for quite a while with it. And I'm a writer, so eventually I started writing and journaling about my feelings and everything that had happened. And something told me, it's like I'm big on trusting my gut. And so something kept saying, like, you need to do something around the kindness issue, right? So it felt for a while that maybe I write a book, right? But then I was like, I'm not sure if I'm ready for that. And then I was like, well, maybe it should be like a call to action on social media, you know, like the bucket challenge. But then that didn't feel right either. So I sort of gave up on that for a little bit. And then I follow Thrive Global, which is a website that Arianna Huffington branched off from and created. It's all positive news, but about like wellness. And I was like, that's what I want it to be, but from a kindness point of view. So I like literally got up in the middle of the night and started formulating the idea. And it just started out as sort of a larger blog. In the meantime, speaking engagements came from it, which I totally did not see coming, right? Which really made me go even more in depth in terms of like why I'm so interested and have always been interested in being kind, right? It's just kind of like part of my life. I think my parents taught it to me, but luckily now with a lot of hard work, just like how, you know, with Beyond TV, it's, you know, starting something new, it's a baby and it takes many hours. It's work after work, right? And now it's become a lifestyle media company is what I call it. We have an online magazine. I hope to do production as well. So that component is there. We now have merchandise. I'm starting to do a little bit of writing and I'm hoping that the speaking comes back now that coronavirus and things are starting to look good. I'd like to get back out because I love working in TV, but I love being live on a stage where I can feel the energy of people in front of me, you know? I say that kindness is a practice. You know, I really do feel like it's a practice, because it's a heck of a lot easier to be annoyed and mean and nasty, right? As opposed to finding the kind component of a situation, or the positive in a situation. And, you know, the self-care component is huge, because, you know, oftentimes we do so much for others as parents, or as, you know, coworkers, for your boss or whatever it is. And we get into this societal just whirlwind that we forget to give ourselves self-care. And then you feel guilty if you take a mental day from work, right? Or if you go and do something that makes you feel good. And so I push that a lot, is how the importance of being kind to yourself and saying kind things to yourself. And another thing is, you wake up in the morning sometimes, at least I do, and first thing you do is you go to the mirror, right? Or sometimes for me, I go to the scale. And either way, you know, it's like you either punish yourself because you weigh heavier, or you punish yourself because, wow, what happened to you? Your eyes are puffy, your hair looks horrible, whatever, as opposed to saying, good morning, how did you sleep last night? Or you tried yesterday to not eat that chocolate bar, but you did, and let's do better today, right?
You know what I do in the morning? I look in the mirror and I do the Fonzarelli, where I go fix my hair and I'm already perfect.
Well, you got to remember, you're Superman.
That's up, Superman.
Yes, you're Superman.
Francis, I love you. Thanks so much for being with us. It's been so much fun catching up with you. And where do we find Be Kind and Company?
So bekindandco.com is the website, but we're on Instagram a lot. That's where I'm post a lot of things. And we have new merchandise. This is one of our Equality Born Kind shirts, because I feel like we're all born kind and then something happens.
That's a good point.
So Instagram is primarily where we are, but also the website has great articles, and it also has the merch, and you can follow me too. I'm Lou Parker LA on Instagram. I'm on there a lot.
There you go. All right, Lou, thanks so much for being with us. It's been a pleasure.
Aw, you're the best. Big hug.
Be kind.
Be kind.